Brought to you by the Deadly Fish Tank, in association with some crazy German, this is 3D MM Late Night. Tonight's guests include Space Goat and from the movie Asylum, Craig. With the help of Kaz Practice, here is your host, Tuna Hematoma.
You think after this show takes so damn long to come out, we'd actually get the name of the guests right at the beginning of the show. Adam, did you not give Marriott the proper lines?
I thought you were supposed to, Tuna.
Yeah, you also agreed with Ruiz that Good Burger was the greatest movie ever, you dumb piece of poop.
Alright, you know what? That's a great movie! I can't remember half of it, but it kicks ass!
Oh, you just go to hell!
Don't push me over the edge, Tuna. I get crazy.
Yeah? You're fat!
You son of a bitch! Nobody move or I'm killing this son of a bitch again. And this time it won't be so pleasant.
What? Kill him again? When was the first time?
Oh, well, you see, I was referring to the fact that he's a mummy and that he's already dead. I'm just saying that now if I kill him, it'll be 10 times worse. Now guess what, you piece of poop! Oh great, now you have me saying that damn poop thing! Time to die, mummy boy!
Okay, go. See what I care.
What? You don't care?
Nope, sorry.
Damn it, Tuna! I only wanted you to know that I love you!
Huh?
That's right, Tuna. I've always loved you.
Alright, Adam. Don't go brinning on me.
He looks like a peach!
He sure does, Adam. He sure does. We'll be right back with Nick the Almighty.
That was the most stupidest thing I have ever witnessed. Ha 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 ha. Ha.
Need help there, little buddy?
Mm-hmm.
Then you'll be glad to try the new and improved stool! Stool from Wemo.
Hello. Do you like movies?
Yeah.
Do you like websites?
Yeah.
Do you like mindless violence?
Yeah.
No! If you answered yes to all of these questions, go to the Hey Mikey Pictures and JMW Productions homepage. Go to it at www.crosswinds.net/mikeyjmw/index.html. Or just click on the link at Tuna's page.
Alright, I know you want to see Nick the Almighty out here right now. But before we send him out here, Kaz and I went to the Golden Jizz Award pre-show, interviewing various 3DMM directors. So, let's go take a look.
Hi, my name is Kaz, and I'm here at the Golden Jizz Award pre-show. Tuna is around here somewhere, and what we will be doing is interviewing the stars as they come in before the show. We hope to get some big interviews and hopefully get some insight on the upcoming Golden Jizz Awards. So, let's go to Tuna with the first interview.
Well, it's kind of early here at the Golden Jizz Awards. There's no one else important, so I'll just interview Tony Teal. Tony! Over here! Your site 3DMM Backlot is nominated for Best 3DMM Website. What do you think its chances are?
Well, Tuna, Backlot's doing just fine, and it's better than ever, actually. And it'll continue to...
It's Will Maltby! Shut up, Tony! Maltby! Can I get a word? Will, you're nominated for numerous Golden Jizz Awards, like Best Site, Best Director, Best Animation, but the important question is, what do you think my chances are for Best Voice Actor?
You motherfucking stupid fucking cunt. Everyone hates you, and they want to see me, alright?
Now that's what I call a backlot takedown.
Crush, 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 yeah!
yeah. Back to you, Kaz.
I'm here with Nuts creator and multiple Golden Jizz nominee, Red Wampa. Now, Red, I have to address these rumors. It seems that some people think you've developed a little bit of a squirrel fetish with all these Nuts movies you've been creating. Is there any truth to this rumor?
No. Those rumors are nothing but lies.
I have never had sex with a squirrel, and I consider you a fool for asking.
Well, okay. Sorry, Red. I just wanted to clear up that rumor. Good luck at the awards. And now let's go to Tuna, who's standing by with the world's greatest animator, Jeff Ching.
I'm here with Jeff Ching, the creator of the Golden Jizz Awards. Now, Jeff, I bet a lot of work went into these awards.
Yeah, I've put a lot of hard work into these awards. It's been tough, but I've had some help, and I...
Yeah, no one cares. We all just want to hear the line from ENS.
You're an idiot. Why don't you shut the fuck up about that? I don't see what the fuck is so big about that line.
Oh, come on, just once?
No! Now get away from me! It is indeed strangely orderly in here, considering the air raid that's going on outside. What the fuck? I didn't say that.
You most certainly did! And now we go back to Kaz with Big Time Harris.
Thanks, Tuna. I'm gonna see if I can get a word here with Big Time Harris. Richard. He doesn't seem to want to talk to me. What, is he too big to talk to late night? Big Time Harris? More like Big Time Loser. And I'll tell you one thing. England sucks.
Now you listen here, Sunshine.
Sunshine?
I've had just about enough of you trying to besmirch my good name. You need to realize that we English are just better than you filthy Canadians. Now sod off! Ah, bloody hell, you incompetent turag. This bloody interview is over, you bloody bollocks bastard.
Sunshine?
Look at you. Do you bloody want some more? I'll smack your bloody bum.
Well, you can't expect much from him. After all, he is English. Well, anyway, back to you, Tuna. I hear you're having some problems with Fister?
Yeah, he is, Kaz. Ever since I made the True Mike Fister, he's been spewing out gibberish, and what he's spewing out, he's not talking to anybody.
Can't touch this. Ooh, doo-doo-bada. Can't touch this.
Mike! I mean, like, what the hell are you?
I'm an albino. I bet you didn't know that. Everyone thinks I'm an albino, but I'm really not.
You are such an idiot!
Sajujo!
You idiot! You broke the camera!
Hey, it's medicinal!
What? Well, it's official. Mike's still an idiot. We'll be right back with Nick the Almighty after these messages.
Everybody's doing the fish.
Man, I can never figure out these wacky puzzles on the back here. Hey kids, this is Pimplando coming at you. Man, I eat a bowl of Wheaties every day. It helps your bones grow good and strong with all its pimpin' goodness. What the fool are you sponsors feeding me?
Wheaties, breakfast of pimps. Now an industrial size.
Tonight on the Nature Channel, don't miss part two of the critically acclaimed documentary, Ducks. Part two of Ducks, tonight at 9 Eastern, 8 Central, only on the Nature
Kaz,
Channel.
Kaz, man, stop with your stupid fake laughing. You're making yourself look more stupid than Damon Friend. Oh, we're back. Well, without further ado, here's Nick the Almighty. No, Nick, I know you're probably pissed at me for picking that as your theme music, but you never told me what music you wanted to come out with! Jeez! Anyway, thanks for being the first guest on Late Night, because Goat didn't do his part! So first things first, why are you leaving the community?
Thanks, Tuna, and yes, Goat is a very big whore. But anyways, the reason I'm leaving the community is just because... it's getting kind of boring, you know, because movies for me takes way too long now, because I always got to make all these custom scenes and stuff.
Yeah, that's got to suck.
Yep. But WrestleMania 5000 is still coming out. Same with PAM 2. WrestleMania 5000 so far has taken me about over a year, and that's a long time. For a friggin' wrestling movie.
Speaking of WrestleMania 5000 and PAM 2, what matches are in WrestleMania 5000? Do you know any idea what's going on with PAM 2?
The first match is with Nick Mod versus Matt McGowan. And that's just a grudge match. Followed by Steve Estill versus Cal Flavel? Flannel? Flavel?
Yeah, just call him the fat kid.
Flavel? That's a hardcore match. And then there's a rumble. Yes. And I don't know what I can tell you with Pan 2 so far.
Well, isn't that amazing? I hear you brought us a clip, and when you introduce it, could you at least be a little bit more energetic?
Yeah, I bring a clip. So let's roll it!
Oh, that looks awesome. So when do you think it's going to be out?
I don't know when it'll be released.
You fool.
Shut up. I don't know. Probably soon in the summer for us. Canadians, that is.
Yeah, because we Canadians rule. Anyway, thanks for being on the show, man.
Thanks for having me on your show, I guess. But these chairs suck, man. My ass is killing me. I'm getting out of here.
Don't blame your ass pains on the chair. We all know you got anally raped by Dan User. Hey, man, get away. We'll be right back after these messages with Jeremy Dick.
I thought about how hard it must have been for him to walk across the gym and ask me to dance, but when I looked down at my bracelet, I thought, what would Satan do? So I said no and set fire to the gym.
Hey, you want a piece of gum?
Oh, thanks.
Ha-ha, that was joke gum.
What do you mean?
Now you're addicted to heroin.
I'm cold.
Welcome back to the show. Now, before we bring out Jeremy Dick, we have a little section on Late Night called Story Time with Brian. Let's go take a look.
Brian? No one's name's that stupid! It's Brian!
Hello, cheerio, and all that plop plop fizz fizz, what a relief it is, yes, look at me, I'm chasing around the cat, I feel I'm so special, yes, that's right, cheerio, blah blah, now I'm going to talk about a pen, yes, this pen is very special, it's a special pen.
Well, that's the best story time with Brian I'd ever seen. So, yeah. So let's bring out Jeremy Dick. Welcome to the dark. Welcome to the show, Jeremy. Now, let's talk about your new feature movie that you're making.
Yeah, currently I've already started working on a movie entitled The Hoodlum, and it's just about the hoodlum goes around town for an entire day, and everywhere he goes he seems to find a different short animated joke. So pretty much it's just several short animated jokes in one movie. And it stars such voice acting talents as you, Tuna, Jeff Ching, Kevin Pellegrinelli, and others.
That's cool. If the movie turns out to be a success, are you going to make a sequel to it? And can we expect more animated jokes from you with The Hoodlum, or feature-length movies with The Hoodlum?
If this Hoodlum movie is a success, then of course there will be sequels to it, as well as animated jokes that I'd love to make, and I will proceed to make them. And I'm also putting plans together for a drama. The script is about 75% done. It's entitled Homophobia, about a drunken homophobic father that finds out that his beloved son is homosexual. And yes, Hoodlum will be in that movie. In fact, he will play a key part.
Oh, so you're making a story about Tony Tulin. I'm sure this is on other people's minds. Why did you change your name to Jeremy Dick?
Well, throughout the course of growing up, many people have ridiculed me simply because of my last name. Some people even refusing my friendship over something I couldn't help, something as stupid as that. People were saying my middle name was Hasno and all that crap. So when I moved to a different school, I changed my name to Jay Clark, so I wouldn't be ridiculed anymore. And when I joined the community, I kept the alias Jay Clark. But after a few years of being in the community, I decided that people should just grow up, and nobody's made fun of my last name in the community, so people have matured over time.
Well, it's a good thing I haven't, Hasno. I'm told you haven't brought a clip of the actual movie, but I understand that the hoodlum is actually here today. Hey, that's one good-looking bitch! I'm gonna go pet that ass! What up, bitch?
Hello.
Hey, do you know who I am, bitch?
A hoodlum?
I'm a doctor.
How the hell did you become a doctor?
Beats the hell out of me. Hey, I'll give you a deal, bitch.
What kind of deal?
I can check to see if you got cancer by putting my finger in your belly button.
Well, I don't want cancer, so I'll let you go ahead and check.
I'ma go ahead and stop.
Alright. Thank you, doctor.
Aight, here we go, bitch.
Hey, that's not my belly button.
Haha, that ain't my finger, bitch. alright. Well, it's been nice having you on the show, Mr. Dick.
It's been a pleasure. I'm sorry Space Goat didn't do what he was supposed to. And you gotta be sure to invite me back sometime.
Will do, man. Well, normally we'd go to commercial and then come back and say goodbye, but, you know, that would just add to the file size, so screw that. I'd like to thank... screw it. They're all in the credits. Just remember this. I'm Tuna Hematoma, and I'm 5'11", biatch.